Yeah. So we have with us Tanveer Ahmed Khan. Needs no introduction. All India Rank 2 in the UPSC Indian Economics Service Examination 2020. Recently, result came and he scored a brilliant marks to get All India Rank 2nd. First of all, congratulations, Tanveer.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Students are also giving a lot of congratulations in the comment section. So all the students, on behalf of them, once again, congratulations, Tanveer.
Thank you. Best of luck for you as well.
Yeah. So Tanveer, you have started your journey from Kashmir, and that's quite inspirational. A lot of students already connected with Ecoholics platform from Kashmir, and I know what kind of inspiration they are getting after seeing you and your name in the final list. So that is an amazing achievement for the student from Kashmir as well as from all over India. First of all, our audience would like to know about how you have started your journey, Tanveer. So in brief, just enlighten our students from where you have started, what kind of efforts you have put in, and what is the background that you have started preparing for this examination?
Okay, sir. First of all, good evening to all of you. So I started my educational journey in a small hamlet where I live. So it's within the encircled by the mountain. So it's a small, beautiful village. So I achieved my basic education from the local government school. So that's why, I mean, one thing in my journey is that I come from a very humble educational background. So it will in itself serve as an inspiration for many students in throughout the country, because I have not received my education from any, I mean, high-fi government private schools. So I have been in the government schools from the very beginning till the end. And after that, I mean, I have done my master's then from Kashmir University. So I reached Kashmir University in Kashmir is pursued to be the premier institution. And most people lack the exposure to the foreign universities. Now it's actually increasing. The exposure level is increasing, and more students are opting for the foreign services. But I did foreign universities, and even the outside state universities. But I did my master's in economics from Kashmir University, and during that era, during an era which was actually surrounded by a lot of insurgency in the state, so
Yes.
education was affected badly. And after that, I decided to move to Calcutta. So while I have recently completed my MPhil in development studies, and it was during MPhil, while I was doing my MPhil, the COVID struck, so lockdown again followed me from Kashmir to Calcutta. So I then decided to utilize my lockdown period for preparing this service. So I decided to once I decided to sit in this examination. And I never looked back. It started like a sprint. So, Alhamdulillah, the final result came in my favor. So I'm really happy about the result.
It's really good, Tanvir, and that you have utilized your time well. And the COVID time comes for a blessing or maybe a disguise, blessing in disguise, but you have proved it that time management is a crucial thing and you can utilize it well, so time will also reward you. So the first question
Yes.
is, how are you feeling after having achieved such a feat? The Tanvir before the result and after the result, how are you feeling?
I mean, I cannot describe the feeling which was, I mean, which is right now. But after the result was out, the first 10 days, they were really, I mean, I was living in seventh heaven. So certainly, I cannot put the feeling in words, the feelings of my parents, the kind of happiness I have provided to them. I cannot describe that in words. But after, I mean, from last 5 or 6 days, there is a strange kind of calmness within me, the calmness which perhaps I was searching from the last 20 years. So I'm really happy about it. So I cannot put in words. So.
That's great. That's great. Then you talked about utilizing the COVID period, but if I ask you more than the study part, if I ask you how a student should prepare this exam, especially because it requires a lot of time, the preparation time, the exam duration, it takes a toll on the mental ability of the students. So how would you suggest or give some guidance to the students to prepare this exam mentally?
So mental preparation is very important. I mean, I have faced issues, mental issues during the preparation. So that's it's very important. So the first thing, my advice to the students will be that you need to be very clear about your objective, why you want to be in this service. And after deciding, after being clear on that objective, the next thing you have to decide is that, am I ready to put the sincere effort? Am I ready to put the kind of effort that's required for this examination to get qualified? Because it requires a lot of work. If you look at the syllabus, so you have to look at the syllabus, you have to look at the previous year papers, and you know, you have to accordingly actually adjust your time schedule. You have to adjust yourself accordingly. So you need there needs to be a mind work, a work that how I should proceed. A framework need to be developed at the very beginning. So you have to be mentally ready at the very beginning, whether I want to be in this service, and if I want, then am I ready to put the kind of necessary effort? So these things need to be at the very beginning. They need to be decided at the very beginning.
Very beginning. Yes, because preparing beforehand is always good because the examination is long, the syllabus is big. So yeah. Coming on to the next question, students ask that this examination is lengthy, the papers required, the knowledge required. Like, there's a myth that if you're from good colleges or university, then only you can qualify the exam, or it requires less effort, or it's familiar for them. But you have qualified from a very different background that's quite inspirational. But according to you, what was the most difficult part of your preparation for this examination?
So when I decided to actually have a sit in this examination, so it was around in July 2020. So I was doing my MPhil. So I finished my thesis within there was a time of around 1 year for the thesis preparation, but I finished that within 6 months. Then there was 6 months left. So I decided to sit in this examination, but I didn't find that because I was from the very beginning a hardworking student. Once I decided to pursue something, I never looked back. It was my habit. But I put an effort in the mains examination, but I found the interview stage very difficult. Interview stage was very difficult for me to handle because once the results were out of the mains examination, I became really anxious that I should not. Now this is the opportunity and I should grab it with all hands. Then I actually tried searching here and there. I found various platforms like your platform and I decided to join with you. So that was really, I found this challenging, and even more challenging when it was postponed in April 2020.
Yes.
20, so I was in Delhi, so it was postponed. I received a message on 19th April and my interview was 20th. So I was in Delhi, so I had to book another flight and go back to Calcutta. So that really was, mentally disturbing for me. But after a few days, my nerves calmed down. So I was again ready to focus on what I was doing.
Yes.
So interview stage was difficult for me.
All my dear students, although he's saying interview stage was very difficult, but I remember the mock interviews that we had, and he was looking very confident, and the panelists were on that platform also saying that this boy will get through the final line. So although, but he prepared well, and you can imagine that if you feel more nervous, then you feel that it's important to you, you prepare well. So I don't think so, Tanveer. I have never seen you like that. That was the most difficult. But
so it was important. That's why I put an extra effort in. And it's a lesson for other students that if you if you think that anything is difficult, then what it needs, it just needs a little bit of hard work and determination that you can conquer it.
You looked prepared. You were like, I want that seat. I want to be the part of that.
Yes, this was my approach.
Your attitude. Yeah, I got it. Coming on to the next one, the examination has four economics papers, GE 1, 2, 3, and Indian economics. And apart from that, two more papers of general studies and general English. So general English is familiar to all the students, as you know, those who are preparing for any examination. But general studies is a different part for the students of economics. So if I ask you, like, what was your strategy paper-wise, starting from the paper 1 to paper 6?
For English papers, like there are, I mean, essay, there is, you have to write an essay, you have to write a precis and a passage. These are the major components of English paper. I think a student need not to put much focus on English, and every student has to analyze his or her English and then accordingly put an effort into this paper. I consider my English not on an, I mean, on an average, I can qualify that paper. I mean, not that good, not that bad. So, but I can do good in this English paper. But still, you have to go. I went through some of the toppers of IES. They have put their essays online. So I downloaded them and I went through them and then I practiced it. That was my strategy. Weekly, I use it to practice it, one essay. But I use it to go through others' essays, toppers, how they have connected, how they have written the introduction, how they have concluded, how they have written the paragraphs. So those things you can also go through those essays. And then precise writing, you have, if you practice one or two, before 1 month of the examination, start practicing some precise. So, and then passage, I think passage is not that difficult. The English paper is not that difficult. If you have passed your 10th, then certainly you will do good in this examination. But then GS part is very random, because you have five portions, but there's one question from ancient India. So you cannot read entire ancient India in order to get 5 marks question. So since the weightage is very less, so you have to prepare this paper in a very calibrated manner. What I did, there are various, actually, I went through some NCRTs of 11th and 12th, and also some online materials. So I searched through the internet, toppers materials are available for history, for political science, for economics. So I went through those materials. And also I used to read newspapers, because mostly they ask from the newspapers as well. So there is a static portion and a dynamic portion in it as well. So they will ask you from geography section, you will get more questions from the current affairs, what is in the news, and even economics. So you will get more questions from what is in the news. So I think they need to focus on newspaper reading. And also there are some ready-made question and answers given by various other platforms like Vision IES. I downloaded them. So, and that also proved very helpful. This was my strategy for paper B, general studies. And paper economics one, which is microeconomics, mathematical economics, and econometrics. So I was at the very beginning confident that I will do good in this examination, in this paper. But since it was my first attempt, so it is a lesson for the other students. So UPSC gives you, for every question, there is a limited space. So it will give you a 2 or 3 pages, and there will be a word count within specific word limit you had to write it. So what I did in my first paper, because my score in first paper is not, I mean, what I expected, but there were some mistakes from my side. So I will list out the mistakes. The first mistake I did was, there was one question, I still remember it, and they have given around 4 pages for that question. It was a long, I mean, lengthy question. There were many parts to it. At the back of my mind was that there are only 2 pages for it, because I have seen only 2 pages to the earlier questions. So I wrote in a jumbled manner, in a very congested manner. Then I decided, I mean, when I saw that there are 4 pages to it, so I was really actually, that hurt a lot at that point of time.
Yes.
So for every question, first look at the space they have given to it. That should be your approach. Look at the space they have given to it, and then accordingly, write your answers. But I think for paper one, I was confident that I will do good, but still I have done good. But you have to be, you need not to be an expert in mathematics or econometrics, but what you have to do, you have to go through the previous year question papers of 5 to 6 years, and then follow 2 or 3 books for microeconomics. Like I followed Pindick and Robinfield and Nicholson for some mathematical portion, and Damodar Gujarati. These are essential books. So if you have gone through previous year question papers, you know what to read. That's important. And for paper B, this economics B, which is of macroeconomics, financial economics, and international trade.
Growth.
Growth and development. So international trade, you have to go through Salvatore. I went through that. And for macroeconomics, Foyn is a good book. And also, sir, this IGNO material, I found that, yeah. I mean, really helpful. The IGNO yes. material for PG, MA Economics mm-hmm. is really helpful. If you don't find any topic on Foyn or any other book, you go through IGNO material, you'll find an interesting material there. Yes. So that's really proved helpful for even paper third and paper third, public economics, environmental economics. So I went through a lot. I was finding it difficult to get it from books, I went through the IGNO material. So IGNO material is a standard material, and most of the time they ask questions from the IGNO material. So I have yes. seen it. Yeah. So they take, just copy and paste the questions yes. from IGNO material. So you can go through the IGNO material as well, but Foyn is a good book to start with. And for international trade, Salvatore. But you have to go through previous year question papers, because if you plan your strategy well, then definitely you will do good in the examination. Yes. So that's the key in this examination. Planning and strategizing whatever you are doing. Yes. Because if you want to climb to the top of a mountain, then certainly there are well-designed, if you have designed your strategy, your path in a sophisticated manner, then there are better chances that you would climb to the top. So that was my strategy. So I went through the previous year question papers and then focused on the areas which the UPSC is demanding. And for paper third, which is for growth and development, I forgot, it was like ML Jingan. Mm-hmm. So ML Jingan is the best book for it. Sorry, sir. And then IGNO material. So you just look at the previous year question papers, and wherever you find that those questions I can get in, you have to write, because everybody is writing in this examination. Your writing should be attractive and it should impress the examiner. That should be your concern. So that's why you have to search each and every question from books where they are written in a good manner.
True.
So you search, where you try, put an effort, because there is ample amount of literature is available online, so you can search it. And I have given you one platform, IGNO, which is a very good platform. You can search from there, various growth models.
Yes. So,
and for public economics, what I did, I found this third paper very difficult. I mean, among the all.
Yeah.
But I had worked hard. That's why my score in this paper is the highest. So if you find any paper difficult, the only thing you have to work hard on this. So that's the key. So I worked on this hard. That's why I scored good marks in this paper. So for public economics, H.L. Bhatia is a good book. But in addition to it, you have to go through this IGNO material. IGNO is the best material for public economics, because they will ask you the questions exactly same from the IGNO books. So please, even if you are not reading IGNO material, give it a read. At least give a read to the questions. So go through IGNO material for public economics. And also for environmental economics, you can search some IGNO material. And Kolstad is also a good book. But go through the previous year question paper and locate the focus areas. And then comes the Indian economy part.
Yes.
In Indian economy, what you have to do, you have to read an economics newspaper daily and make notes. What I did, I read Financial Express and sometimes the Business Standard, and I made notes. Yes. And 90% of your syllabus of the paper is coming from those newspapers. Yes. And for the static portion, you can go to the Uma Kapila.
Yes.
So that was my strategy for this examination. And for the interview stage, I actually searched here and there, and I reached to your platform.
Thank you, Tanvir. And it's for the students, one thing is important, that you should not read any book cover to cover. You just go and searching for the topics that I mentioned. So this is what Tanvir summarized.
Yes.
Tanvir, what would you suggest as the key things to do while preparing for answer writing?
So I think one thing, as I earlier told you, you are writing and you have to impress the examiner. So for that, what you have to follow a simple strategy. Your introduction should be good, it should be interesting, and it should be representative of the question they are asking. Secondly, your conclusion should be good and optimistic. You should always conclude on an optimistic note. So that was my strategy. And body, you can put enough material in the body, but you have to keep the in consideration the word limit, the space that's given to you. That should be taken at. And also, important thing, you need to be to the point. Suppose in our GS paper, there was a question of like causes and consequences of perhaps the Kuwait India resolution. There was this a question of this sort. So what you have to write a generalized introduction to this question in two, if it is a one page, they have given you one page, then you have to write the introduction and conclusion in the same page. And also you have to underline the causes, and you have to write some causes in points and then consequences, because they are asking you, you need give me the causes and the consequences. So you underline the causes, write some causes, you underline the consequences, write some consequences, and nothing else. Because wo aapki wo baaki jo aap masters mein karte ho, they are not interested in that. Whatever they have asked, you have to write only that. Suppose they in economics third paper, they ask what are the objectives and the rationale for economic planning in developing countries. So you have to give a generalized introduction first, an introduction which will be representative of the question as well as the body which you are writing. You have to write an optimistic conclusion. And in body, you have to write, firstly, my strategy was underline the rationale and write some points under it. Underline the objectives and write some points under it. So in this way, it becomes to the point.
True. That's great. You have summarized in a very, very crisp manner for the students. Yeah. One last question from my side, then we'll move on to the doubts of the students. Why did you choose Indian Economic Service over your current work assignment or any other competitive examination?
I wanted to be an Indian economic officer because I loved economics.
Yes.
So I love talking economics, walking. I mean, while I was walking, I used to think about economics. And I have a lot to learn economics because I'm a student of economics. I have a lot to learn from my colleagues who are with me in this service. I have a lot to learn from great minds of this country. And I like to learn economics. And I think this is the best platform, and particularly from the area from which I come. So we don't have other platforms where you can learn economics better. So I think for me, it was the best service because there are other services, but since I was interested in economics and there was a service for economics, so then why search here and there? Just I focused on this service.
Great. Every success is having a story and some kind of inspiration behind it, that person. So who inspires you most in your life?
I mean, sir, I believe, firstly, my family, my parents, like my father, he has been a very hardworking person. And my uncle, he has always been a disciplined person. So both have contributed in my life. And then there are many teachers who have inspired me at different stages of my life. There is no single person who has inspired me, because up to 10th, there was one role model for me. After 10th, there was another. And when I reached higher and higher levels of education, there were many people came who have inspired me. And right now, many other people are inspiring me. So I don't think there is a single person who can be an inspiration throughout your life. There are many people who come at different stages of your life, and they contribute in your life. They somehow show you a way. And in my life, I mean, if you talk of static inspirations, my father and my uncle, they have been my static inspiration, and there are dynamic ones who come and who leave an imprint in my life. And I just want to thank them all that they have been in my life.
That's great, Tanvir. Now we'll move to the question answer session. So any student having any questions, I'll just read out in the
comments
section.
Yeah, go ahead. I would love to answer your questions.
Yes, I'll see. My dear students, which we have already discussed, I'm not taking that again because Tanvir has already covered these kind of questions. So yeah, regarding strategy, syllabus, books, we have already covered. What are the various sources? So sources we have covered already. I think which book is best for referring microeconomics?
This is a question. I think Pindick, Rabenfield and Pindick is the best book for this examination.
Okay. And apart from that, any book, any other book that you have referred only?
Nicholson. Nicholson will be the best book.
Okay. Yes. The next question is, what are the various internet sources for preparing for IELTS?
Ecoholics is the first. I mean, if you are preparing for IELTS, then you should connect with Ecoholics. Secondly, there are other platforms like various IAS platforms who are putting their materials online, like Jagran Joshi, you have Vision IAS, you have Drishti IAS. So I actually look.
Yes, GS related current affairs.
Related. Yeah, GS related.
Yes. Because answer writing remains same, whether you're giving civil services or.
Yes. So the trick is that what I have told you.
Yes. So there are a lot of congratulations, by the way.
Thank you very much.
So now students are asking, what's the best time to start the preparation? The person who's asking is in MA first year doing from IGNO.
Okay. So I think there is a Chinese proverb, the best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago and the next best time is now. So the best time, in my opinion, is your master's, in my opinion. And some are prepared because master's is the eligibility. So you need not to take pains preparing before in your graduation. Since the eligibility is master's, I think you can prepare it. Start in your master's. And if you are not prepared for this examination during your master's, then the next best time is now. So decide it now and go for it.
Next question is from Muhammad Ismail Mir. Sir, please suggest tips how to improve writing skills. I mean, how to write in the answer sheet in a limited time. I think, Tanvir, we have already covered, but still, if you want to throw some light on it.
Yes, you have to practice it. I mean, there is no easy shortcut solution. You have to practice it. The more you practice, the better you get at it.
Yeah. Next question is, he's asking, which book is best for Indian economic development? I think economic development is asking.
If it is economic growth and development, I think firstly you have to go through the previous year papers. There is M.L. Jingan, there is A.P. Thirlwal, but you don't have to read the entire book. Because UPSC syllabus it's given, so go through syllabus, go through previous year question papers. So then you have to study some models, and those models you can find from IGNO material. I think IGNO material is the best. And if you don't find some topic is from IGNO material, look for M.L. Jingan or A.P. Thirlwal.
Okay. Munaz Masid is asking, what was your stream at plus two level and undergraduation?
At plus two, I had economics, mathematics, political science, environmental science, and English. And during my graduation, I wanted to go for civil service. So I opted for history, political, and economics.
Okay. Yeah. Sonia is asking, sir, my English is basic, is not much good. Can I do good in this exam?
Oh, my English was not good, but it's a matter of 1 month. So you can learn. Put an effort into it. हमारा भी ज़्यादा अच्छा नहीं है, कुछ ज़्यादा टेंशन नहीं लेने की ज़रूरत. You can do great.
Yeah, you can just express.
Yes, that's yes.
Enough. Yeah. Vinay is asking, sir, how was your interview? Like, what were the questions in the interview they asked?
Oh, interview stage. I think, I mean, when I went into the room, so they never asked me about my introduction. They knew it because they had my DAF in their hands.
Yes.
So this. First time, the first question came like, tell me the difference between growth and development. But it was a cordial atmosphere. So the question was not tough, so I answered it. But there were some questions which were very tricky, like one panel member asked me that you are representing India at World Economic Forum. So take 15 seconds and start, give us a speech for 2 minutes. So that actually for 15 minutes that went like in a thin air, so I cannot concentrate what I have to say. But then I said something But when I came out, I thought that it's good. I mean, it is not that much bad, not that much good. So it was normal.
Yeah.
But the atmosphere remains very cordial.
Well,
I was not nervous. I was confident.
Yes. How long it was?
It was around 35 minutes.
35 minutes. Okay. Next question is, sir, I want to know about the study routine, your study routine.
I started very late for this examination, for preparing this examination. That's why I have to put in extra effort into it. I used to study for around 10, on an average, 10, 11 hours. So because that, I started very late for this examination. There came a notification in 2020 that there will be no examination this year. So after that, then came another notification. Now there will be an examination and there are 15 seats. So I started in July. So exam was in October. So I prepared for around three to four months. So that's why I put an extra effort. But if you are preparing during your master's, then 6 to 7 hours is enough for this examination per day.
Yes. Next question is, tell us about your note-making strategy, how you make notes during your preparation.
Okay, I will share with you a tip of how I used to make notes. Suppose I used to read newspapers daily, and there are many topics who come frequently in the newspapers, and from every article you get something new. So what I used to make notes topic-wise. Suppose there is right now the agricultural laws that during that period of time, the agricultural laws that were passed in the parliament, that was a hot topic. So I underlined, there was a space I kept on a plain sheet. I underlined the topic was agriculture reforms. And then whatever I was getting toward the entire preparation, I used it to put it under that heading. So that was my strategy. Topic-wise, note making, and whatever you get, whenever you get, put it under that heading so that when you actually revise them in the examination, it will become easy because everything will be under the same heading and at a particular place.
Yes. The next question is, there are situations of frequent internet shutdowns in the valley. How would you manage your studies?
I think, yes, sir, definitely in Kashmir, we have a special problem that we have frequent internet shutdowns. But when I decided to move outside the state, because I was preparing for this examination in Calcutta, so there was not this problem of internet. So for me, it was not for this, at least for the preparation of this examination. It was during my master's. It was a major, it has given me a hell of a time during my master's, but it was not during the preparation of this examination. But right now, I think the situation in Kashmir is improving, though we are witnessing less frequent internet shutdowns. So I think now you can connect with an online platforms. This will not be a problem. I hope. I mean, this is my good hope.
Yes. That was quite unfortunate, but you have managed to do that.
That's yes, great. Yes. Sir.
Yeah, Shivan is asking, did you miss any question from each of the paper? Like, were you able to attempt all the questions or if you have missed any?
No. So I have missed, I mean, in my GS paper, I missed around 20 marks questions because I didn't get the enough time to write entire thing.
Yes.
So in my GS paper, 20 marks. And in then economics first paper, I missed one question.
Yes.
So because there is, you have to write much quickly because they ask a lot of questions and then the time is limited. This time management issue was with me, but still I managed to write whatever I was writing. I wrote that in a good manner so that the examiner will be impressed. But yes, I mean, around out of 1,000 marks, I attempted around 920, 930.
Yes. There's a one question frequently appearing in the comment section, like it's simply copy-pasting it. Which newspaper and magazine did you read specifically for IAS? I think Panvir has already answered, but yeah, just wanted to listen from you.
I think Financial Express is a good newspaper. You should read that. And since you are preparing for GS as well, Indian Express, Financial Express, they are not that much costly and you can also get a lot of knowledge from those papers. And magazine is, you have Yojana. Read Yojana constantly because that will give you a government's perspective And also be careful, you should never criticize the government in your answer writing.
Yes.
So you need to be very much supportive of the government. So, I mean, you can critically, if you have a question like critically evaluate the agriculture laws, you can write the constructive criticism.
With proper solutions.
Yes.
It's not just you're criticizing, because we have to write about the policy, not about the implementation.
Yes.
Yeah, that's great. Any magazine like EPW or other things? I think
EPW is also great, but I used to follow the RBI. There are other RBI reports that should be read, like financial stability report. You have RBI's monetary policy report. You have Government of India's various reports, World Bank's reports. Though they became the news, you will come to know about them from the Indian Express or the Financial Express. Then you have to go through those reports. But Yojana is a good magazine. You should go through the Yojana.
Mohammed Zafar is asking, your interview is held in English only, or it's kind of a both Hindi English?
No, it was in English only.
In English. The exam is only in the English media.
Yes. Don't fear English, because even if you don't speak well, they will not judge you on the basis of English.
Yes. Arjun is asking, how did you approach econometrics and mathematical part of general economics one?
Look, for mathematics, if you fear this portion, I think since I had a mathematics in my 12th, so I found it not that much difficult. But if you find it very difficult, then the only way to do it is to practice it more and more. And for that, I also practice it, even though I used to do it with a lot of ease. But certainly, I also practice it a lot, like from Nicholson. So Nicholson has a good mathematical approach. So if you are comfortable in reading Nicholson, then that should not be a problem. And this Pendik has also mathematical portions. So go through those mathematical portions and practice as much as you can. Econometrics, there is this Bible for econometrics, Gujarati. So you have to go through that. But read specific portions, because they are interested in some particular sections of econometrics. So if you practice those for around a week or 2 weeks, I think that should not be a problem. So my approach was also the same, that I used to practice those questions.
Yes. Megha is asking how to pick out relevant information from newspapers. Like, no need to read full newspaper. Students want to know the areas.
The first page is very important, because it will give you a sense of what the government of India is doing and how it is addressing various economic issues that the country is facing. And then there will be a commentary in the editorial page. There will be the independent opinions from different economists, from different famous analysts. Then you have to read those in the op-ed page. And then accordingly, you will get an idea what I have to keep in mind.
Okay. Yamini is asking, how did you retain all the graphs and model? And what were the ideas where you were preparing these, how to remember graphs and models?
So, the most important thing is that you have to practice it more and more. Suppose particularly the graphs in the international trade. Salvatore is a book of graphs. So there are a lot of graphs. So the best thing is to practice it. Suppose you have studied the optimal tariff from Salvatore. The best strategy will be to practice the graphs. Try to make in your mind the graphs in your mind. That will be I used to make graphs in my mind, if not on a paper. Even while sleeping, I used to make graphs in my mind. So that's an important strategy for graph making. Yes. And you also should practice it.
Yes, practice is the only a solution for that. Yeah. So Nuruleen is asking, how you have overcome fear during interview?
When I entered into, there was a bit of nervousness within me, because I come from a very remote village hamlet. So although the hamlet is very beautiful, but it's very remote. So I was lacking a bit of exposure, and that I feared that it should not be a problem for me. So, but I was fearing for that. So when I went into the interview halls, the atmosphere, they have created an atmosphere which is very cordial.
Yes.
So it is very harmonious. So entire nervousness went away. It went into thin air. So I didn't feel, I was very confident while giving answers. I was sometimes arguing with the, they were not agreeing with me, but I was arguing with them. So on money trip also, there was a debate, there was this discussion. He was not agreeing with me, I was not agreeing with him. But this was a gentle, I mean, I used to tell them, sir, I will go through it again. But in my opinion, whatever I have read, I think this is the correct way to go. But he was not, actually, he was not sure. He wanted to test me. I think then he accepted at the end, yes, you are right. So then he...
He was just checking the candidate.
Yes, yes, he was checking me. So they will check you, not your knowledge. They will check how confident are you. And how able you are to defend what you have said. So you need to be very, I mean, cautious what you say, because you have to defend that.
Yes, it's true. So how many people were there in your board?
There were four people.
Four people. Shiv Kumar is asking, sir, I'm pursuing my master degree in economics from Delhi School of Economics. So my question to Ahmed, how to start preparing of IES at the initial stage? I think
so,
we have covered, but
yes, we have covered it. Yeah. You just have to. I mean, if you are doing your master's, then you have to follow your master's syllabus, because most of it will come from your master's syllabus, and you have to read your master's very well. I mean, if you focus on your master's very well while doing master's, I think this examination will not be a big deal for you. And also at the same time, make a habit of reading newspapers.
One last question is, which university in Kolkata did you study at?
It was a research institute of development studies, Kolkata. And it is affiliated with the Kolkata University. The degree is awarded by the Kolkata University, but it's working independently.
Okay, great. Tanvir, I think all of the questions we have covered, all of them are mostly repeated. So all my dear students, just see the video once again when we'll end this live session. You'll get all the answers there. If you still have any doubts, you can ask on our email IDs and the phone numbers. We'll communicate to Tanvir and then we'll get back to you. At last, Tanvir, if you have any words for Ecoholics, what we are doing for the students.
Yes, definitely. I came to know about this platform very late, but I was unfortunate. So Ecoholics platform is a good platform for economics. The name itself suggests the name is unique in a sense, but it gives you, for all economic students, it gives you, I mean, everything on a single plate. So if you want to do, if you want to pursue your career in economics and want to be successful, I think this initiative by SAR is a great initiative, and people, more and more people should connect with this platform. You are doing great service. I mean, the Thinking Tree, your program of Thinking Tree, it's a very innovative and an interesting idea. Why you invite different people from vast experience, I mean, famous economists, and I have actually learned a lot from those videos. I used to watch them while preparing for this service. So you get a sense of what, if you want to be a successful economist in this country, I think Ecoholics is the platform to look for. So I wish Sir Ecoholics best of luck. I will always wish it.
Thank you, Tanvir. And those students who are preparing for 2022, we are organizing a free counseling session as well, where you can interact with our faculties and including me as well as the panelists. Then you can ask all your doubts if you want to enroll in our courses, test series, and there are a lot of programs, answer writing, mentorship. There's a discount coupon, Independence Day Freedom 10 sale is going on, so you can avail that coupon, Freedom 10, just you have to type and to avail that discounts. Once again, Tanvir, congratulations to you, and thank you for taking out time from your busy schedule to be the part of our session, and students were really waiting since the result came, and it's a great achievement for the students as well to interact with you live on our platform. And we would love to have you again whenever students demand.
Definitely, sir. Thank you. And thank you for your love and for the gifts you have sent to me. Thank you for that.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Just wait till the end.